Hello students, today we will learn guidance and counseling. Okay, mention this now. Guidance is the process of helping individuals to understand themselves and their world. किसने बोला ये शेडजर एंड स्टोन ने. ओके, ये अपना डेफिनेशन है, इसको आप नोट कर लो. देन आईएम ब्रेवर ने क्या बोला, गाइडेंस इज प्रोसेस थ्रू विच एन इंडिविजुअल इज एबल टू सॉल्व देयर प्रॉब्लम एंड परस्यू ए पाथ सूटेड टू देयर एबिलिटीज. डेफिनेशन ऑफ काउंसलिंग, काउंसलिंग क्या है उसका डिफाइन मैं करूँ, आप सुन लो. ये counseling is defined as face to face relationship in which growth takes place in the counselor as well as counselee. ye kisne bataya, kiske according hai, kaun hai iska psychologist, Strang. counseling then Stone and Shatgar ne kya bola ye dekh lo. counseling is an interaction process of facilities meaningful understanding of self and environment and result in the establishment of goals and values for their future behavior. Then principles of guidance and counseling. Principles dekh lo bete. Guidance and counseling is universal requirement. Guidance and counseling is goal oriented. It is continuous process. It has evidence. It has growth and development. Professional activity. Prevention as well as cure. Then it has flexibility. Cause and effect. Development of insight. Then areas of guidance and counseling. Social, moral, occasional, educational, marital, health. These are the types or areas. Then education. Guidance and counseling is an important in education. It will provide assistance to perform satisfactorily in the academic works and also helps to those choose appropriate course for the study. It helps in overcoming learning difficulties. Expert assistance is also required for enabling the student in making proper adjustment in relation to general academic life. Adjustment to effect maximum intellectual, emotional and physical development. Types of educational guidance. See, pre-admission guidance needs, post-admission guidance needs. In this occasional, in which student need guidance for assistance provided for selection of occasion and preparation for the same and concerned with enabling clients to acquire information about career opportunities. Then avocational. The assistance is to be provided to clients to spend their available leisure time profitably, such as game, drama, fine arts, and have recreational value. Health. Health guidance is integral part of society for the preventive, promotive, curative, and restorative measures has to be provided to ensure the achievements of these objective. Then moral guidance. For the student who are having undesirable practices, moral guidance has to be provided to keep them in track and lead noble lives. Then see personal guidance. Students face many health problems related to themselves, their friends, family, teachers, educational achievements and social adjustment, feeling of disappointment, unfavorable atmosphere at home, poor studies, strained and unhappy interpersonal relationship, progress in study is hampered. Expert guidance has to be provided to those students to face the situations with confidence. Marital guidance. Students may need guidance for the right choice of a life partner or for happy marital life. Types of counseling. See, number one, directive, number two, non-directive, then short-term, student-based, clinical, effective, long-term, psychological and psychotherapeutic counselings are there. Then in placement, occasional, individual, problem-solving, dietary, behavioral, group, motivational and interpersonal. Then what is directive counseling? See, this counseling is also known as prescriptive or counselor-centered counseling, because in which counselor have an important role on solving the problem by giving emphasis on the problem. Counselor is supposed to be an authoritative person and have to identify, define, diagnose and provide a solution for the problem. Non-directive counseling. This type of counseling is also known as client-centered counseling, in which counselee is the active participant and counselor is the passive participant. The counselee is the pivot. He takes an active part in the process of therapy. He gains insight into his problem with the help of the counselor. He only decides and takes necessary action. Short-term counseling. This kind of counseling is used in situational crisis which can lead disruption of life, which concern of the client or family or community. It can be relatively minor concern or major crisis, but whatever the situation, it needs immediate attention. Counselors will assist the client and guides problem solving in a systematic way or decision making in logical way. Okay. Then what is long-term counseling? It extends over a prolonged period of time. It may vary daily, weekly or monthly basis. It is focused for the client who experiences developmental crisis may need long-term counseling, like women with menopause, women with breastfeeding. Electric counseling. The counselor will use both directive and non-directive counseling methods for the purpose of modifying the ideas and attitude of counselee to know the client's emotional expression. The techniques are elective in nature because they have been derived from all sources of counseling. Then clinical counseling. It is used for the diagnosis and the treatment of mind functional maladjustments and to find better adjustment and self-expression. A relationship primarily individual, face-to-face between counselor and client. It describes the problem and also suggests the solution or remedies for the problem. Psychological counseling, in which simply on conversation between client and therapist. This may take in the form of questions and answers, reconstruction of past history or discussion of current difficulties. It consists of catharsis by the patient or the therapist. Make an initiative in making the patient to speak out his repressed feelings and emotions. Psychotherapeutic counseling. Psychologically trained individual consciously attempt verbally to assist the other persons to modify emotional attitudes which the subject is aware of the personality recognition through which he is undergoing. Then student counseling. It is concerned with helping the student to solving his problem pertaining to the choice of educational institute, courses, methods of study, adjustment, vocational choice, and etc. Next one, placement counseling, in which counseling in regard to job and post which are suitable to the client depend upon his abilities, attitude, and interest. Then important questions such as type of counseling approaches, basic principles of counseling, characteristics of counseling, the guidance and counseling. Okay, you learn now at home. Okay, bye.